Hey everyone. All right, let's not do that. Today is a very special order and I'm so excited to do it. I am going to be completing an order for my best friend Helen. She asked for a bunch of coasters for her family and for herself. This video is just gonna be making coasters for her. I already started on this piece because I had extra resin, and she wants a beach and a sunset coaster. So I'm gonna be making that. There's a sand dollar, some shells, and a little cutout starfish. So this is already dry, it's already done. I am going to be doing some layers. I'm telling you guys, I am so stoked to do this. Oh my goodness, anyway. My next order that I'm gonna be doing is a Harry Potter set. I actually have two orders. Well, technically three. We're still on the edge of that. We don't know yet. If you guys want to watch me make a little beach scene and a sunset sky and also a cat bowl, then please continue watching. gosh, these coasters are to die for. Oh my gosh. Beautiful. Just after adding the gold around it, I feel like it just makes them pop. Amazing. And then there's even like actual sand. I added the gold around this one as well. Here's the cat bowl that I did. I added a gold rim around it as well, and I feel like it just pops. Pops. Real quick to end this video, I wanted to share an experience that I had. This making of the coasters and the cat bowl, I was actually working during the day, and normally I work at night, and I don't know if the resin in the cup got too hot or what, but it started hardening so fast. I mean, it was like it was steaming. It was way too hot. There was already a hardened piece in the center of it. I couldn't even use it anymore. I feel like sometimes I get ahead of myself and my craft brain is just thinking and thinking and thinking that I take my time. And I don't realize that resin has a working period. It has like a specific time frame for you to be able to work with it. And I failed. I don't think I failed. What I'm gonna try and do is take this cup and just peel it off or something and maybe sand this down into something. I don't know. Like, I want to turn it into a happy accident. Thank you, Bob Ross. It's okay. I am definitely taking this as a learning experience. Make sure I work with resin quicker than I was, and do not leave it out in the sun. Resin naturally, with its chemical process, gets hot. I mean, heat is its best friend. The hotter it is, the faster it's going to cure. I also am making like an extra resin thing. It kind of looks like tie-dye to me. With all my extra resin left over that I have, I'm literally just pouring it in here. I don't know what to do with it. So anyway, that's what this is. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I learned a lot and I love making these pieces. I feel like they turned out amazing. Yes. I'm so excited to give these to my friend Helen. Oh my gosh. Okay, leave a like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe, whatever, you know what to do. I am taking off and gonna go make some dinner, but I hope you all have a blessed day, and that's it for me. See you guys in my next video.